Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here in this video series, I am explaining you the concept of circular linked list. So in this video series, I am explaining you how to create a circular linked list, how it is different from SLL and DLL, and how to perform different operations on a circular linked list. So before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the insertion operation on a circular linked list. These many operations we can perform on a circular linked list, they are just same as of the SLL and DLL. But how to operate circular linked list through these operations, that I am going to explain you in this video series. I have already explained the operation to create circular linked list. I have again already explained how to traverse a circular linked list. And now let's begin with the insertion of node in a circular linked list that we can insert at these three different positions. From which, let's start with at beginning. How to insert a node at the beginning? So for the insertion of the node at the beginning, we have this linked list with us, from which this is my head node currently. But whenever I want to insert a new node, I should have to create a node first. So let's create a node at different address location. So I have created a node. After that, what is my next step? My next step is assign head to the next of the new node. So this head node, current head node, we suppose to assign it to the next of this newly created node to find or to form a link between these two nodes. So after doing these changes, you can see over here the logical link is formed between these two nodes. Then what we have to do, we have to traverse the circular link list till next of the node is head, means you have to traverse till this position. Let's traverse it. Why to traverse at this position? Because this is a circular linked list, and now the circular linked list is holding the address of previous head. Now as we want to insert a new node at the beginning, now this node is going to become a new head node. So that's why the address of this new node will get replaced with the next field of the last node of the linked list. So that's why update the next field of a current node with the new node. So let's see over here, I am changing the address location, that will be the address of the newly created node, and it will form a link to the new node, a circular link. And now the last step is to make a new node as a head node. So let's remove this head from this position and let's make this node as a head node. So these are the steps we are supposed to follow to insert a node at the beginning of the circular linked list. Now let's start with the insertion of a node in between into the circular linked list. So let's assume this linked list is with us, and we suppose to insert a new node in between into the circular linked list. So first of all, whenever we want to insert a node in between, what we have to do? We have to need to traverse the circular linked list till the desired node. Why? Because after that desired node, we are going to insert a new node. So for this, first of all, we have to use the traversal technique, traversal algorithm, starting from the head node. So let's assume I want to insert a node after 20. So let's start from the head node. Let's check whether that is desired node. No, this one is also not desired node. This one is the desired node after which I want to insert a node. So now at this moment, what we have to do, we have to create a new node. As we have created a new node, after that what we have to do, we have to update the next field of this newly created node with the address of the next node, that is the current node ka next we supposed to paste over here, you can see, and it will form a logical link between these two nodes. Now what will be the next step that we have to follow? We have to update the next field of a current node with the address of the new node. So let's update it. You just look over here, and I am updating this address, and after updating, this link will get vanish and it will form a new logical link between these two nodes. So in this way, the new node is added in between into the circular link least. Now the last point where we can insert a node at the end of the link least. So let's insert a node at the end of the link list, a circular link list, is that now let's assume this is my circular link list is available with me and I want to insert a node after this particular node. How could I come to know this is the last node? By knowing the address of the head node, we will come to know that this is the last node and after this I have to insert a node into the circular link list. For that, let's start the traversal till the end of the list, and we are at the end of the list by identifying the next field is holding the address of the head node. So let's stop at this position. After this, let's create a new node. The new node is created. After that, what we have to do? We have to form a link between these two nodes. So let's see over here. I am changing the address of the next field of the current node to the newly created node, that is 65930, and after that what we have to do, this link will get removed and this null field we have to update with the address of the head node. So now let's see what we are going to do the next thing. So let's remove this link and after that let's update the field of the next field of the last node, that is newly created node, to the head node to form a circular link in a circular link list. So in this way we have inserted a node at the end of the list. So here I have explained all the three ways with which we can insert a node into the circular link list. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment as well as do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks, along with the next video of this video series is nothing but how to perform deletion operation on a circular link list, and the whole playlist you will get from here. So thank you friends. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.